Evernote have had a little bit of a bumpy time recently, although some positive news for many of those who have been waiting for an update from Evernote. It has come with new pricing changes and the addition of new features. But many people have been actually struggling with their Evernote account with syncing and speed and reliability of opening notes. Today, we're going to look at some Evernote alternatives to help you find something different if you have lost faith in Evernote. But for those who are curious about what Evernote has recently added, we actually did an interview with the Bending Spoons team that dives into a few of those updates, which will be linked in the description below. Now, before we begin, it's really important that you don't dive into these alternatives. Research is really fundamental to finding the best productivity tools, but naturally, we'll guide you through all of that in today's video. So welcome, my name is Francesco. I'm excited to dive into Evernote alternatives. I've done this video several times over the years, probably about three times over 10 years, despite naturally Evernote still being about. And although they don't have their 100-year-old mission that they wanted to aim for, naturally they have been acquired by an app development company based in Italy called Bending Spoons. Today we're gonna look at three categorizations of alternatives, and they are like-for-like alternatives, ones that are close and ones that are slightly different that might give you a different perspective on note-taking that you might want to embrace. Before we begin, you can check out all the Evernote alternatives in our list below, which we'll dive into them in a bit more detail, and you can go and explore each of these, making sure you do that fundamental research to finding the best note-taking application for you. Okay, we've had a long enough intro, let's dive into the Evernote alternatives, and I'm going to start with like-for-like alternatives. So I've picked out three like-for-like alternatives, and I wanted to start with one called Nimbus Notes. Now, Nimbus Notes feels and looks a lot like Evernote. It actually has a lot of features and experiences that are similar to Evernote, including a really quite advanced web clipper that allows you to do video and audio capture, and naturally is limited by some of the free plans, but offers quite an extensive ability once you get into it. Now, the look and feel of it, as I said, very similar to Evernote, and presents a really clean way to take notes in a very traditional fashion like you would with Evernote. Although this doesn't really go into the advanced details that Evernote have recently added with Tasks and Calendar, it does offer a good, similar experience to Evernote. Next up is AmpleNote, and this is one that is really not so good on the design. Just a note, it is very old school looking compared to some of the other tools we'll talk about, but it does offer probably a few more features than Evernote had for a note-taking experience. And it's been a rising star at the note-taking space for the last couple of years. Now, AmpleNote itself presents a way to take notes, but it also combines tasks and calendars in there too. It allows you to take tasks down and be able to add a lot of different context points to it, allowing you to whisk that up, well, the algorithm, to whisk it up into something called a task score, which is quite a neat feature if you're somebody that struggles with prioritization and managing your tasks in based on urgency. Adding all those details to it will give it a score, and then that will rank based on your score, which will help you to work your way through the most important tasks on your list. And it also has calendar functions as well, which helps you take meeting notes alongside calendar events. And that's similar to what Evernote was really advancing in the last couple of years with tasks and your calendar. Although this takes a little bit longer to learn, to be honest, it's one of those applications that has quite a few features when it comes to packing in a really solid notes experience. Next up is Notion. Now this, again, is not definitely like for like, but it does present a custom way to build your note-taking application, because it's so flexible as a canvas for you to build whatever you like, and it's got a ton of features. More recently, with databases advancing, you can do a lot more powerful things with artificial intelligence with it. Database templates, database building views, and different options allow you to create a custom way to manipulate all of your notes into the right view that you want. And Notion has actually become a note-taking application for many millions of people, despite also having options for tasks, projects, and wikis for your team as well. So Notion should definitely be, if you've not moved already, over to an Evernote alternative that you should consider. Okay, so some of these are close to Evernote, but not necessarily as close as the ones I previously mentioned. And I want to start with UpNote. This is an application I reviewed here on Keep Productive probably a few months ago now, and I was fairly impressed with it. The application was well built, and it presented a really much lighter weight version of Evernote that was stable, easy to use, and pretty reliable, to be honest. And this is a decent alternative if you're looking to slim down your note-taking abilities and maybe don't want to necessarily import from Evernote. Again, this is again much more suited for those who are taking much lighter forms of notes, maybe not so PDF or document or even image and video intense like you would maybe in Evernote, but definitely an option to consider because it's a lot cheaper, which is one of the reasons why people are moving from Evernote at the moment. Next up is NotePlan 3. And again, this one is a good alternative to Evernote because what it presents is a way to manage your task calendar and notes in one location. And it has a really slimmed down feel, but presents a great way to start taking notes and even use daily notes to manage your tasks and your calendar event in advance. But this NotePlan 3 is very much Apple-centric, so those who are with Mac and iOS devices will love it, but for those who don't, probably won't get on because it's not available on those devices. Next up is Bare Notes. It's been expanding quite a lot and very much like UpNote, presents a lighter weight version of note-taking compared to Evernote. But it presents a good option, and I believe in the near future being a couple of months, they're going to be releasing Bare 2.0, which might introduce some improved features and enhancements that many people have been waiting for a long time. And actually, the final one, Mem. Now, before we begin, I am actually a Series A investor in Mem, just a disclaimer, but it doesn't change my opinion here on the channel to naturally give you the best opinion on a productivity tool. Now, a few years ago, I did say that Mem was the new Evernote, and it does present a lot of similar features to it, but it's definitely gone down the AI route since naturally last time I checked it out, and it does present a more slim way to take notes in comparison with Evernote. It won't naturally be able to really be able to upload heavy notes, but it naturally is something that is a blend between something more advanced like Obsidian and something naturally like Evernote. It's a slight upgrade when you come to think of it in terms of advanced functionality, being able to link notes together and utilize AI, but naturally is something to consider because it is a slight change from what you're using with Evernote. It's very untraditional in its sense of organizing your notes because there are no folders, no necessary systems, and there's a lot to learn with templates. So that's a consideration to have a look at in the near future. So these are some of the other applications that are on my mind when it comes to alternatives that are slightly outside that might take you to a different foundation that you might think about note-taking. So these could be PKM tools, ones that are completely different to the original Evernote concept. And the first of those is Obsidian. Obsidian is a really beautiful note-taking application, and it presents a Markdown-like experience with some pretty advanced capabilities with linking notes, connecting notes on a graph, and the new Canvas feature allows you to expressively bring notes together for connecting ideas and be able to visualize things that might be on your mind. Now, Obsidian itself presents itself as a really nice free note-taking application. And a lot of people like it because of the security aspect of it. Whilst it does have online syncing, it actually has a default option that is installed on your device. So it won't leave your device unless you move it or naturally that other stuff happens to it. But a lot of people like that, the having their vaults naturally locally stored. So Obsidian is a big alternative for Evernote, but it's one that will take a bit of consideration, especially if you're somebody that has come from a traditional note-taking background and wants to move to a more PKM, more personal knowledge management approach, which might take a little bit of time. But here are a few other alternatives that use PKM. Next up is Reflect Notes. This is similar to Obsidian, but presents a more relaxed, natured look and feel to it. And it's much more approachable. It's got daily notes, connects to your calendar, and naturally allows you to add tasks within your items. And the tags are a little bit more approachable than what you see in Obsidian, because it follows a more of a structure when getting started. But Reflect Notes is slightly pricier, which actually is something that might put a lot of people off when they've been looking at the Evernote pricing, but one that is attractive and an option when you're considering PKM as your next solution to note taking. One that is also similar to Reflect Notes in a way is Capacities, but Capacities builds their notes from something called objects. This is a new type of note taking called object-based note taking. And the concept is really interesting, because what you do is essentially create an object, and you can create objects ongoing, which means it's sort of like a studio, allowing you to create objects for the new things that come in. Say you've got a book, or even an author, or maybe even something that you're referencing for later, like a study, or maybe even a person in your account. These objects will help you to organize your notes more effectively, but it does take a little bit of work straight up front. So it's one to consider and one to check out in a bit more detail. Finally, my other Evernote alternative is MyMind. If you're looking to change your approach to note-taking in terms of making it easier to capture notes that are more visual, maybe like videos or links, or maybe even images, this is actually a really good option. Imagine if Pinterest and Google Keep had a baby and advanced it with AI, this is probably what that would look like. This is one to consider. It's a bit of a contrarian compared to the other ones I mentioned, but again, these sort of applications becoming much more popular for being able to capture stuff on the go and be able to visualize that when you go into the account. So folks, those are all of the Evernote alternatives. There are lots of them, and of course, I'm sure the comments will be full of other people talking about their own experiences moving away from Evernote, or potentially thinking about that move. So feel free to check out the comments. We've got tons of tools on Toolfinder, which you can find linked below and naturally up in the cards here. But if you want to explore more productivity apps, you can go there. You'll find the alternatives listicle that we actually created for this, which will help you to go into much more detail and naturally explore the best one for you. But one thing before I go, research is so fundamental when finding a productivity tool, because you actually have to take that time to really grow deeper and really understand it in a much more depth. And spending that time can feel a bit daunting initially, because you're obviously investing a lot of time and not jumping into a tool. But it's a little bit like that Abraham Lincoln quote. You spend, if you give me 6 hours to chop down a tree, I'll spend 4 hours sharpening the axe. It's probably butchered it, but it's similar to that in the concept that refining what you do before you start hacking away might be good. So hopefully that gave you a bit of a window into the Evernote alternative out there. Thank you very much, folks. I look forward to seeing you in a future video. So do make sure to subscribe, and naturally, I'll see you in a future video. Check out Toolfinder in between. See you later, folks.